part of me that, oh right, because that's how Dark Souls works. Finally! Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3, and I finally dealt with that silly monster. Actually, I only died like an extra two times, but... sheesh. Also, I totally screwed that up. I wanted... Wait, why did I do that? I need to refresh. Oh, whatever. I don't even know anymore. Yeah, that was a tough fight. I kind of had to pull it out into the other room, because this room here is not the best place to fight it, apparently. Well, that was a pain. Alright. Fully healed up, back to my normal talisman. And yeah, I'm using the longsword because it's such a fast character, or fast enemy that. Figure it should. Also, with the ring that I have, that the one that I gain health from successive attacks, as far as I can tell, that works when you actually attack. Like, it doesn't seem to be based off damage. It's not like, oh, anytime you attack, you gain health. It's if you attack like 5 or 6 times, you start regaining health. So I think the longsword is a better option for that. And now we have the Road of Sacrifices, a brand new area. Oh, I just go to Firelink Shrine down there. That's cool. So yeah, brand new area. Let's see what's here, although hopefully it's not more frozen enemies like that last one. So yeah, be there in a sec, just skip over the leveling. Okay, and we're back and starting along this Road of Sacrifices, whatever it is. Okay, we're not like Darkwood Garden. The trees are not enemies. But there's enemies in the trees, probably? Maybe? What is that thing, whatever it is? Oh! What? Okay, that's gonna be annoying. Oh, I guess it doesn't really help if they're dead. Anyway. Well, that's interesting to know. Okay, so there's some sort of weird angel-like enemy that actually takes a little time to... get going if I hit it. Or bird-like, I suppose. Is anything gonna attack me from behind if I hit that thing from above? Nope! See ya! Well, it's a lot easier when you get a plunging attack, that's for sure. What's down here? Shriving stone! Okay, this sounds like something new! Sounds like a stone for infusions. What does it do? Oh, one does have an infusion. Okay, cool. Okay, so it's the new Pale Stone. Good to know. More wagons. Right, so this is kind of the Forbidden Woods, as far as I can tell. Like, the Bloodborne Forbidden Woods. I know. Every single area I go to, it's like, where's the Bloodborne reference? What's the Dark Souls reference? What's this reference or that reference? I'm just looking for references everywhere, because so far I've found a lot of stuff that, well, it does just feel like those other games. Looks really nice, though. Unknown Traveler Soul. Do these have enemies in them? Not as far as I can tell. Okay. Also, before I go to those, did I miss anything down here? Nope. Okay. Ooh. Okay, something in the distance. Nothing really above. Potentially a way of jumping between one and the other. Nope. I probably should have realized because the height wasn't really correct for that sort of thing. Okay, guess we gotta deal with whatever's up front. Oh! Ah, there's the trap. Ah, seriously? Oh god, all these enemies all at once. And poison! Alright, so one of them's coming at me. Just drag it off, and then worry about the rest later. Yeah. Still not sure I'm supposed to regain HP from hitting things. It doesn't seem to really be happening. The heck is that noise? I don't like you. And you can't actually fly, so... sucks to be you, I guess. Wow! I didn't even have to touch that one! Alright, so that's poison. I don't really have any poison resistance, but you weren't hitting me accurately. So eat jumping attack! And I'm still not regaining health. Okay. There'll be a little icon under my status bar when the health regain stuff comes up. It looks like a few claws. And that hasn't been happening, which is weird. Not really sure what to make of that. Well, what do we got here? Try a ranged battle. It's not a big deal. Anything down here? So easy to miss things off the cliffs, like little ledges and such that actually have nice goodies on them. Especially with big cliffs like this, where it looks like if you were to try to go down anywhere at all, you'd die. So it's always good to double check, but it looks like, no, the path is over here. Sort of. In a bit of a one-way kind of way. So let's just see. So it looks like I can go down here. And then I have no idea. Well, nothing's down here to try to kill me. Something's up there, which is bound to jump down. Why are you not jumping down there, hey? What's wrong with you? Well, whatever. Nothing down here to trap me. Ah, wait, there's someone. I don't know if I like that look. Wait, is that? Oh, come on. You gotta be kidding me. That man-eater Mildred? Ow. Ah, come on. You gotta give me a chance to do something. Oh, great. But yeah, that's totally man-eater Mildred. Okay, is that whole Bloodborne ring thing even of any use? Like, I don't seem to regain health with it. What's the point? I attack and I attack and I attack and it does nothing. I feel like I'm just... it's just dead weight. But yeah, another Dark Souls 1 reference. Man-Eater Mildred was actually an invader in 1. And she wasn't that bad, all things considered. So, I'm not sure what to think, but yeah, I don't know. She was really minor in that game. I'm actually kind of surprised they bothered to even put her in. Okay, I'm not going to bother with the others right now. Looks like that was just a path to an item, so I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to worry about... whoa, okay, never mind. I actually do have to worry about it because that's the way to get to the next area that I was just losing my souls in. Get over here. There we go. Come on, lazy bones. Come at me. Oh, well, there you go. Seriously, though, if I get the Ring of the Evil Eye, it's probably going to replace this ring. Because that's probably a more useful way to approach things. Alright. They going to jump at me again? Nope, because one of them jumped at me. Someone just straight up jumped at me. There it is. Oh, that's his approach point, huh? Ugh. Okay. No. No, that's not gonna work. And seriously, this is not regenerating health. Yeah, it recovers HP with successive attacks. That's what it's supposed to do. I'm hitting? Maybe I'm missing something. Maybe it'll show up in the video. Whoa, okay. What? Not gonna let you do whatever you're planning on doing there. Okay, that was like 6 attacks. Unless the hollowing status gets in the way of that. I mean, right now it's 24, so maybe it does. I mean, if it does, that would make sense. Like, that would be why I'm having a hard time with regenerating health. Okay, where's Mildred? Well, I got a counterattack in at least. Oh, right. I probably should not roll or not attack until I have no stamina left. I just want you to die! Get out of my game, Dark Souls 1 reference. Seriously. I don't like that. I mentioned at the beginning, I don't want that many Dark Souls 1 references. Now there's been 3 so far. And I also want to really test that ring. That's why I'm dying. That's why I'm so aggressive. It's like, that ring's got to work sometime. But it doesn't seem to. Someone's gonna have to tell me how it works. I'm not gonna look it up, because that might spoil other things. But yeah, it just doesn't seem to work. Which bothers me. And otherwise, it's like, I don't get it. Why doesn't it work? Alright, I have to deal with this. Ah, too late. Too early. Just die, will you? Nope, no regeneration, so I don't know what's going on. I can only guess hollowing, but I don't want to spend a bunch of souls to remove the hollowing so far. If I can find a way to permanently reverse it, permanently undo it, I might as well, if it's causing the problem. Oops. No. Shoot, no. Wasn't on crossbow. I was on healing. Which is not what I wanted. There we go. But yeah, bringing the evil eye would be a much more efficient way of healing back up. And at least I didn't lose too much. It's not like I wanted that mace that Vort Soul would have made me. Because that was the option, the mace or this ring. Alright, let's just fight Mildred for real. What the? Oh! Right, because Great Machete has that option, doesn't it? Which is the sharpen thing. Hmm. How that? I don't... When do I attack you? This is so annoying. I probably have to cut out some stuff just so it doesn't get boring, because I've done the same run back over and over again. Haven't changed much. Talked about some stuff. But I've been rewatching my Let's Plays, and maybe I just have a really short attention span, but I need to cut my own stuff so that I don't end up boring myself. I don't know what it's like for you guys, but That's why I've been trying to edit fairly aggressively, because I want to show new stuff, I want to show a bunch of interesting stuff, I want it to be interesting, I want it to be something that I'm willing to watch, but then again, people seem to like it, so I have no idea. And people seem to like what I have so far without actually doing all that stuff. So I don't know. I don't know what works. Okay. Regenerate stamina. And that misses. I mean, that was a bad roll, but it got me out of the way. It was not an iframe roll. That was a roll to dodge. And you can just die. And where's the other one that comes down here? Oh, maybe it has to be called. Okay. This doesn't appear to be acting like the undead sunlight. I don't seem to be getting attacked or anything based on any... Oh, there's a path that's not Mildred. Well, whatever. Mildred's the wall I'm bashing my head into now. Okay. You and your dung pies! What the? Why did I lose? Why in the world did I just lose my lock on there? I mean, I realize with the keyboard and mouse I don't need lock on that, but... I know I don't need lock on that badly, but it's still a thing. Ah, finally Mildred goes down. Oh, it's the butcher knife, which I'm imagining has the same properties. Oh, it looked like it actually regained some health. Nope, just sharpen. Okay. Same kind of machete-like weapon. Oh, that actually would have been a fine place to fight Mildred. Ooh, brigand stuff. What is the brigand stuff? Hood from a foreign land, probably belonged to a brigand who met his match. In foreign lands, undead were banished to send a message to the populace, and when the message was not heard, they banished the living too. How does that look? It's okay. It's not great. I don't really like it. It's the brigand armor. Same description. Not much difference in anything else. Oops. Just also a question of weight. Yeah, brigand gauntlets. Kind of the same thing. Although, slightly better than what I'm going for right now. At least for absorption. And brigand trousers go over the limit. Not what I want, but okay. So I guess we can run with the hood for now. I mean, if I can find the sorcerer set and the sorcerer set actually has the sorcerer's hat, I didn't check if it would, actually. But if it does, we're going to totally rock the sorcerer's hat. Ooh, that's a cool thing. Twin daggers. I can't use it due to lack of dexterity, but it's basically... Oh, okay, so this has the Bloodborne Dash thing I heard about. And it's also, you two-hand it to get dual-wielding. It's kind of cool. If they do something like that for crossbows, then I might actually do a dual crossbow build. Because, yeah, I know, I keep harping on about the crossbow kata thing or whatever. It's kind of funny, I haven't even seen Equilibrium. It's basically just because of a few fighting games and such. Like BlazBlue and Arcana Heart. It's really a bizarre fascination. Come on, give me your wings, and then... Yeah, okay, now I'm getting that health... Or... I think it's a health boost. I mean, that... The status icon showed up, finally. And I'm gonna loop around. What is my current Titanite shard count? 3! One more, and then I can upgrade my Claymore or Longsword. My current soul count. Oh, wow, I've got another level. I have another level in the oven right now. Okay, you get slashed. Oh wow, there's a lot of you now. And you're largely pissed. Well, I'm not gonna fight you here. Let's fight you where I'm not gonna roll off to my death if I roll. Because that's actually a real hazard. Just chop you to pieces. What the? No! No! I thought you were dead! Ugh, stupid last little smidge of health bar. Great, not gonna do that all over again. Maybe I'll just homeward bone to get that level. That's a lot of souls. I don't want to lose that. Probably need endurance. That does seem to still be a bit of a problem, especially with this ring. It feels like I need to have a lot of endurance for this ring to work. Because that way I can swing a lot. And also so that I can actually swing away at monsters like this, and... At this point, it requires a full stamina bar for me to kill them. Obviously, upgrading my weapon will help that, but upgrading my stamina will also help that. And it also means more swinging and more attacking, more cutting! Like so. I may occasionally sound insane while doing this, because I probably am. Hey! And I got that status condition again, which doesn't last very long, because I don't have the stamina to make it last. Darn it, you will die at my blade! Like so. Alright, so I did retreat a little bit, which means I should have my souls readily available for pickup. There we go. Let's go back and deal with the two that are going to be a problem if I... presumably, if I don't deal with them. Try up front here, and then around. Then... yeah! Oh, whoops, I ran out of stamina. That was bad. Cut! 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 That barely regenerates health. I'm getting really annoyed by that. There's something I'm missing, unless it's just damage. If you have to deal a certain amount of damage. It doesn't seem to be. It seems to be specifically the number of swings, which means it would work really well with, like, those bandit twin blades or other dex-based weapons. And work like crap against weapons like the... or with weapons like the Claymore. But then something like Evil Eye would work really well with the Claymore. And you're annoying me. I'm gonna shoot you out. Who needs lock-on? Oh, what? Oh, shoot. Okay. Back to areas I can dodge in. Okay, no, 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 no. Oh, wait, no, I'm dead. How do I deal with that? Man, these things are annoying. I don't know how to deal with this. Maybe I just have to run up to them and try to cut them. I mean, that seems to be the way to go about it, is just run up and cut them up. Anyway, I'm just going to pick up my souls and level up, and then I'll meet you guys back up when I'm at a point basically where I left off. Okay, what's this? I picked up another gem. It is a holo gem. Creates holo weapons, which I guess... oh, luck boost attack. Okay. I thought it was something like hollowing boost attack. Not what I was hoping for. Anyway. Still on the run. Actually, you know what? Let's just keep going. Pretty close to where I was, so... let's keep on the run back trail. Or actually, maybe... I'll keep going. Oh, nope. There we go. What? Pillage? Corvian Great Knives. That's the thing against me? What is this? Dagger of the Unwanted. Those guided by heretical storytellers. A rather large dagger with a powerful attack, but this transparent attempt to intimidate foes reveals much about the owner's fears. And the skill breaks through guard. Okay, wow. And I'm not using a shield, so it doesn't really affect me too much, but... wow, okay. Cut, 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 cut! Well, only one of them's coming after me, so... so far, so good, I guess. And... cut! Nope, not enough. Not enough cutting! Cutting was not sufficient. I needed to resort to shooting. Alright, well that takes out one of the three. Leaving the other two... oh, darn it, no. Oh, whoops, that's one too many shots. And now I just cut you. Because I have a full stamina bar and... okay, I got that status effect. I don't know how this works at all anymore. Sheesh. And like I said, I thought I was just cut the thing. Oh, no, 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 no! Darn it! Well, those souls are lost, then. Because that was not a reliable way of going, and I just had to hit one too many times. I wish I knew how that stupid ring worked, because I see that status effect pop up, and I think, okay, that means I've got to be attacking a lot. Got to be attacking with light weapons that hit a lot of times in order to regain health. Because that's how it works, but I can't even tell, because it doesn't seem to work consistently. You're assuming that it's that little plus that I'm seeing that's actually what I care about. Well, in that case, I saw it after one attack, so I don't know. Got to keep a really close eye on my health. No, it definitely only seems to happen when that plus happens. But I think that plus is just after, like, a bunch of attacks in a short span of time, you get some HP back. Like, you get just a flat amount of HP. It's not like Bloodborne where it's... Yeah, that's what it is. You get a flat amount of HP back. It's like Evil Eye, and I guess it was in combination with the Evil Eye, it worked really well. For those of you not familiar, the Ring of the Evil Eye is another item, which hopefully is in this game. It's been in every previous game. Which gives you health every time you kill an enemy. It's about the same amount of health, too. It's like... I think that's about 30, 23 health right there. Cut you, and then... Cut you, and I should be able to get the health... Yeah, there's the health up. Again, that little orange plus, or little orange up arrow with the shield there. That's the health up. Of course, now I've got to deal with the fact that I don't really have a safe way of getting back at all this. I can cut you, though. I can cut you, and I just need to move away so that I avoid any problems. Although I'm getting a lot of souls from killing these guys. So 10,000 is actually not that hard to get back if I need to. Cut! 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 Oh, right. I'm always doing one too many. Partly because I'm fairly certain that doing that actually gets me a little extra, but I'm not sure. Okay, and you're gonna go bursting out. There we go. Bursting out like that is... Oh, no. Ah. There we go. And regained a bit of health. And I got my souls back. Awesome. Got everything I needed. And my crossbow's loaded. Now all I need to do is cut this thing so that I don't accidentally drop off a cliff. Like so! Well, okay, drop off a cliff to my death. Though, granted, I said accidentally, that was an intentional drop off a cliff. And another ember! Alright! How many embers do I have so far? 7. That's not a bad number. I may use one. Is there a bonfire around here? Is this a boss fight area? No, it's probably not a boss fight. Of course, then again, I totally miscalled it earlier. So maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it is a boss fight. It's clearly a lower area, too. I mean, I did see before I could go down... Oh, I see. Okay, okay. I think I see how this works. I'm curious. I don't think Mildred's spot was a path to that, but let's just double check to be safe. Nope, totally separate. Okay, looks like I need to drop down. All signs point to having a drop. Where do I drop from? Can I survive such a drop? I would say find out in the next episode, but we still have a bit of time. Oh, actually, no, I won't be able to find out at all. Never mind. Looks like I can't really drop there. What? Really? There's no real way to... No, looks like nope. Well, there kind of is. I might be able to drop down here. But it looks like it's about as high as that earlier ladder thing that I died at. So I feel like that's suicide. So... I'm going to consider discretion the better part of valor and see if I can find an alternate route. Because, oh! And I can! It's actually right on the other side! Dropping would have been needlessly unsafe. Oh, it's still dropping. I'm just not dropping as far. Okay. I know, healing is kind of weird, but eh. With the heal spell, I mean, rather than using Estus. Wow, I hit it so hard it went right through a cliff. You're not going to go through a cliff, though. You're going to respect the Pauli exclusion principle. Hey, the divine donut, the Braille Tome of Kareem. So there actually is a Braille Tome and another ring. All right, we have stuff to read to close out this episode. All right, so first off, the ring. Since I think we know what the Braille Tome is, it's for Irina. Boosts miracles. Malformed ring given to the Knights of Kareem. Boosts miracles. Morn served the goddess Katha and later became an apostle of the archbishop. They labored together to provide comfort to the suffering. So it boosts miracle power. Well, I don't really need bleed resistance right now, and I can hold it, so yeah, sure, that's a great idea. Oh, if I could just find Ring of the Evil Eye. I mean, Ring of the Evil Eye on top of this would actually, I think, be okay, because the Pontiff's Left Eye is okay, but Ring of the Evil Eye on top of this would mean that deaths would get me HP and a lot of attacks get me HP, so it would work well against bosses and against mooks. And I don't really need the Tearstone Ring that much, but it's not bad. Actually, come to think of it... okay, bleeding doesn't seem to be a big problem. If I could get, like... There's other resistances. Poison resistance would be kind of nice. And the other resistance I really like is... I think... Oh yeah, frostbite resistance. Because I don't even know what frostbite does, but whatever it does is bad. Or I'm presuming it's bad. Alright, so I will close this out here. And I will see you in the next one. Stay tuned until then. Or rather, have a good night until then. And then tune in when that comes out.